to try to make it better in Ohio, but we still have a long ways to go. We come a long way.
So back in Cincinnati at a really special place, the Underground Railroad Freedom Center. I'm here with Woody Keown. Talk about this center and the mission and really what it means to not only the Cincinnati community, but to all of Ohio.
Well, this center is, we opened in 2004. We have been a pillar in the community since that time. We find ourselves in a situation where we are promoting social justice. Our vision is to create an educational institution to provide inclusive freedom across the board for everybody. And it comes through the lens of the African-American experience, the African ancestry lens, and tell the story from that perspective. That's the main thing we try to do. Because if you do that and solve those issues and get people to understand and educate people around those issues, we know that everything else is going to, everybody else is going to get better as a result of that.
So I've always thought of Ohio as a beacon of freedom in many ways. We haven't always lived up to that, right? But it's something that is a big part of our history. So why this location on the banks of the Ohio River, right across from Kentucky? Why is this great institution here in Cincinnati?
I'm glad you asked that question, because the location is very, very important and specific here, because if you look across the river, it wasn't quite as wide as it is now. Yeah. But across that river were people in an enslaved situation. And on this side of the river, if they could get across and make it, yeah, people became free.
They so were Ohio in free meant territory. Freedom.
Ohio meant freedom. Ohio meant freedom for a lot of people.
Wow.
And we had in this area also, because people, a lot of slaves, this was like the first stop to freedom for,
sure,
a lot of the slaves. This area became a, kind of an economic community for a lot of African Americans who've been coming out of enslavement.
Sure.
And this area not too far from here was called Little Africa.
Okay.
Because there was a strong African American community. So this was like the first stop, and many slaves came through this area and continued further north.
Wow. Well, thank you so much, Woody.
Thank you. We're glad to have you.